Hey everybody, it's John, W5CYF, and welcome to the Ham Shack. Today's project is going to be replacing the RJ45 clip or connector on the end of an Icom HM-103 microphone. Now this microphone is used on several Icom radios, specifically the one I have is the Icom 703. However, this RJ45 connector, modular connector, is used on several small radios, QRP radios, field radios, and mobile radios, and so forth. Now, it's kind of a catch-22 on these. In one way, I can understand why they're used so often, and that is it is a very convenient way to hook your microphone up. You just press the clip and shove it in your radio. When you get ready to remove it, of course, place the clip and take it right out. That's the positive. The negative is these are very flimsy, easy to break, don't take much pressure on each side, and the little clip is always prone to break, and that is exactly what's happened to this clip right here. The connector is still in good shape, but the clip is broken. Therefore, when I put it into the radio, it always wants to back out. So we're going to take a look at how to do that, specifically on this Icom here with the correct wiring diagram and so forth, so stay tuned for that. I'm going to have all the parts in the description down below of everything that I used. What I'm going to be using today is this. It's from, got it off Amazon. I paid for it myself. And it is the crimping tool along with the RJ45 connectors. This delivered was right at $15, and this is the fall of 2018. And those are United States dollars. And again, I'll put a link down there. You'll need this or something similar to this to put that connector on. So right now, I'm going to show a little slide, one or two, to show you the wiring diagram that is specific for the Icom 703 or my specific Icom 703. If you're going to be doing this, of course, you'll want to make sure that these color codes do match your specific radio. So right now, let's go to the slides. First, let's take a look at a couple of tools that you're going to be needing to complete this project. Obviously, you're going to be needing some RJ45 crimp type connectors. They're also known as Category 5 connectors. You will need some kind of a crimping tool to attach the connector to the cable itself. Check the description below for a link for both of the connectors and the tools that I'll be using in this video. First, let's talk about some nomenclature. This is the RJ45 connector, and I'm calling the clip side, I'm calling one side of the clip side, and then the bottom of it is the flat side. And depending on how you look at that is going to be the way the wires run. Now, if you're looking at the clip itself, if you're looking from the top, from the clip side, this would be your sequence from left to right. The first one would be empty, then you would have your blue, then your white, then your black, which would be a shield. Then 5 is green, 6 is empty, 7 is the black wire itself, and number 8 is empty. I find it easier when I was doing this to actually go from the bottom side or the flat side. You can see your wires better. If you're looking at the flat side straight on, if you just turn the clip over to the wide side and look at it from the back, the first one would be empty. The second slot would have your black wire. Your third slot would be empty. Fourth slot would be green. Your fifth slot would be where your shield goes. 6 is where the white wire goes. 7 is where the blue wire goes. And 8 is empty. Now, what's not shown on here, when you cut your mic in two, there's going to be a red wire. I just clipped that red wire shorter than the others, so it would not connect on the RJ crimp connector. So that is your wiring sequence. Now let's go into installing the clip itself on the microphone cable. Okay, I'm out in the shop here, and I am about to continue on with repairing this microphone, the HM-103. And I do have the kit that I got off Amazon, and in it, as I was saying a while ago, it's got 100 of those little caps on it. And in here is the, well, let me open it up. I have not even opened it up yet. But there's the crimper, and then there's a little tool right here to strip the cover back on the mic cable itself. So I've checked, double checked, and it's time to go ahead and clip that off. Now the next thing I'm going to do is go ahead, and I'm sure something on here is going to show me maybe what to do here. I guess I need to figure out how long I need it. So I need to strip it back. It looks like that one is stripped, but I'm going to leave a little bit more so I can cut off the ends even with a pair of scissors. So I'm going to strip it right here. All right, looks like I got a nice clean cut with that one. All right, so at this point here, I'm going to go ahead and straighten this out, and looks like that shield is all wrapped around it. So I'm going to go ahead, straighten this out, and then and take out all of the cords and so forth, and then try to get everything straightened out. I'll come back when I do that. Okay, at this point, I've taken the dykes and I've cut it off, and then I used a scissor to square up those ends. Another thing that I did was on this shielded braid here, there's actually a copper wire, and it looks like more of a silver colored wire that's in there together. I suppose what that is a shield and the ground. Went ahead and connected those together. It looks like from all the indications that's the way it should be. And I should say that by now you should be realizing that you're doing this at your own risk. If something happens, you will want to make sure that you have verified everything that I do. This is the best of my knowledge, but of course I'm not an expert at this by any stretch of the imagination. Another thing that I did was I took part of this shielded cable and cut about half of that out, because it's going to have to slip up inside that little groove inside this little RJ45 clip right here. And another thing that I did was I just put a drop of super glue right on the very end of that braided wire. Now, I've tried to do this a couple of times off camera just to see how it was going to look. Oh, and another thing that I did also was I took my camera, and on the old piece, I took some pictures of it, and then I was able to enlarge those just to double check that my wiring was correct. And then on top of that, I took my Dremel tool. This is a part of it. I did take the Dremel tool, and I just cut the other one apart, and just once again to visually verify that I do have these correct. If you have an Icom 703, you may have read some warning signs about some ground and how it can blow out the voltage regulator if you have something in this microphone hooked up incorrectly. And as I said before, you're doing this after you do your own research and not on anything that I do. But I've tried to be very, very careful about these. I've spread these apart, and I've also read that this is much like building a ship in a bottle. And I've tried this, as I said, a couple times off camera, and it is somewhat tricky getting this all in there together. So I'm just going to do this off camera, and when I get it right, I'll come back and we'll do the crimping. Well, this video is about to take a real quick turn. First off, I have completed the end and installing it on the microphone here, the HM-103. But it's going to take a turn in this way. I was not able to show how I put this on there. Installing this was not an easy thing to do, especially I've got a little splint here on my wrist, so that was a little troublesome. But even without that, the putting the wires in the right slots in the RJ45 connector was challenging, to say the least. Here's a couple of things that if you're going to do this, I recommend. First, I made a mistake. I should not have cut the original end off of here. If I were to do this over again, I would take a Dremel tool and I would slice along each side and try my very best not to cut into those wires. The reason that is, the shield on the original mic cord has a covering on it that, well, for lack of a better word, encases the ground. When I cut that off, then all I had left was the shielding that was that small wire that shielding is like. So then I had all this wire that I had to take care of. So what I ended up doing was splitting about half that wire off, or cutting about half of the shield off, then winding that up very tightly, soldering that together. And even after I soldered it, then I had to take an emery board, a nail emery board, and actually file that solder point down to get it small enough to go inside the groove where the wires go, because that shield has to be grounded also. The other issue is there's some skipped spaces in the connector here. So you don't just shove them in and hope they get right. You've got to be able to move each one of those wires around because there's three empty spaces in here. Two or three empty spaces. that are in here, and they're not all together. So some of those wires go, you know, two here and then four over there and so forth. It's pretty tricky getting it in there. And then finally, if you were to do this, what I ended up doing was taking a straight pin to help guide those individual wires, especially that shielding wire, because it's not very stiff. When you put it in there, it wants to keep bending back and shoving up into the corner. So it was not a quick snip and shove it in that connector and go back. In fact, I started on this yesterday, and I've been working off and on this for really a day, trying to get everything just right. It was not an easy task. It was it was somewhat difficult to do. It's not impossible to do, but there's more than once during this whole thing, I asked myself, why in the world did I cut this off? Why didn't I just continue to use the mic like it was with the broken clip? I will say this, I'm going to take extra special care on this clip right here and hope that it doesn't get broken. If it does get broken, I'm going to go in and slice out each side of it, and then hopefully just be able to push the wires back up into another new one. The other thing I thought about while I was doing this, MFJ sells a replacement microphone. I know nothing about that microphone other than the fact that the catalog shows it with a modular connector and does fit Icom radios. And it's priced in the MFJ catalog for $24.95. I think if I had to do all over again, I would pay the $25 and go ahead and get the microphone. Of course, you would not have the up and down, and I'm sure it may not be the quality of this microphone here. It may not, or it may be. I have no idea, no way to test it at this point in time. But anyway, it can be done if you take your time in doing it. And who knows, yours may slip in the first time, and I just had a great deal of difficulty doing that. Anyway, that's the story on repairing the HM-103. It can be done. It is tedious. You may want to consider, oh, and by the way, this microphone, to buy this microphone is about $100 to get this replacement Icom. So I figured I had nothing to lose, everything to gain. If it didn't work, I was going to go the MFJ route. Anyway, enough said about that. I hope you've learned a little bit about this if you ever have to replace a RJ45 connector on your Icom microphone. This is John, W5CYF. Until we meet again, we'll catch you on the air.